In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Leap Motion Interaction Engine. The Interaction Engine allows us to grab small objects as we would in real life. Now, it doesn't work 100% accurately, but I think it does enough to get the job done. Here's what the final result will look like. To use the Interaction Engine, you'll have to download it from the Leap Motion site. Now, this Leap Motion Interaction Engine comes in a package, so you're going to have to import it to Unity when you're done downloading it. Now, before we get started, I'm just going to set up the scene. I'm going to include a plane, which is going to be like our table. I'm going to add a cube, that will be the thing we can grab. And I'm going to add a sphere, just to show some collisions later. Now I'm also going to color the cube purple just so it's easier to see, and I'm going to bring it close enough to our hands so that we can actually grab it. Let's get started. First, I'll add the Interaction Manager prefab from the Interaction Engine module into the scene. Then I'll delete the rigid round hands under hand models, and I'll add the brush hands. Now these brush hands can also be found under the prefabs folder in the Interaction Engine. Then I'll go to the leap hand controller and rename this physics hands into brush hands. I'll set the left model to be brush hand L and the right model to be brush hand R. Then I'll go to brush hand L and I'll set the interaction manager. I'll go to brush hand R and also set the interaction manager. Now there should only be one interaction manager right now because we only have one in the scene. Make sure the pickup has a rigid body. And to it, we will add the interaction behavior script. Now just click autofix. And by default, the interaction manager and material fields should be filled in already. Now let's hit play. Now, as you can see, it was a bit hard to grab, so this is going to take some practice. So there's actually one small problem with the way we set up the interaction engine in the last section. The problem is that we didn't set up layers. Now, to show you what I mean, I'll just hit play. And as you can see, the pickup object doesn't have a layer, which can be problematic if you're setting up your own physics systems that need to know what layer an object is in for it to interact properly. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to set up manual layers. So we're going to go to tags and layers and add three new layers called interaction, interaction note clip, and brush hands. Then we'll go to our interaction manager and we'll set the appropriate fields with the appropriate layers. Now, when we play it, if we stick our hand close to the pickup, you can see that the layers change. And although we won't be using layers in this tutorial, you might find that this may fix any bugs that you might have, or just may be useful when you want to start adding other stuff to this as well.